Good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. So today we are not giving any view on Nifty or its direction, or we are not giving any view on different stocks, but we'll just mark the support and resistances because we have expiry today and we have budget session tomorrow. So we'll just mark the support and resistances and see how Nifty reacts to them with the budget that is going to be announced tomorrow. So first of all, 10,900 on the upside is a strong resistance, and 10,630 on the downside acted as a very strong support. So here for the first time price faced a rejection, then this candle also it faced a rejection. Now even on 29th Jan also we had a doji kind of pattern. Then we have this trend line support earlier. So when that got broken, it got converted into trendline resistance now. So it will, what all matters here is if this trendline resistance is going to get violated or not. If it gets violated, then again a sharp price on the upside. If not, and if it continues to come down, then a sharp fall on the downside. So just note down the levels, 10,900 on the upside and 10,630 on the downside. Now remember that today is the last day of this month as well. So the pivot points. Now as per the pivot points, 10,730 is our central pivot point. So that already got broken. So from tomorrow onwards, we'll be getting new pivot points. So we'll need to see from tomorrow what are the new pivots and is Nifty on the bear side or is it on the bull side. So that we'll get to know tomorrow based on the closing price of today. But on the very higher time frame like monthly and weekly, so it is trading below the central pivot point. So there the price level is 10,850. So Nifty is trading below that. So on a very higher time frame, Nifty is bearish. On daily time frame also, as per current month pivot points, it is in bearish zone, but from tomorrow onwards we are going to get new pivot points. And value of RSI, it is taking support near 40. So this is the most important point that we need to observe here. We know that a value of RSI, it tends to oscillate in between 40 to 60. So in between this, it is going to be a sideways zone. Above 60, it will be super bullish, and below 40, it is going to be super bearish. So from the month of November, we have not seen Nifty's RSI value to trade below 40. Even if there was a sharp fall here and a sharp gap down, even in that scenario also, RSI did not go below 40. And even this time on 29th Jan, when there was the low made, even on that day also, we did not have value of RSI trading below 40. So now it becomes very clear to us that Nifty will be bearish only when value of RSI goes below 40. One more important point is it did not settle above the value of 60 for so long. It went up and the next day itself, it came down here. Even here also for around 3 to 4 trading days, it remained above the value of 60, but again it came down. So as I say, every time value above 60 will be bullish, value below 40, the stock or index will be bearish. So it's always better to find out your bullish opportunities only when RSI is above 60, and find out your bearish opportunities when value of RSI is below 40. So as of now, we have marked our support and resistance levels. But if you see, the current market price of Nifty is very near to the support level. And a value of RSI is also near to the support level. So let's see if it breaks this trendline resistance or not. Now on a 15 minute time frame, today's pivot point, that is 10,700, that itself is acting as a strong resistance to Nifty. This is just for intraday purpose, what is going to be the view. So yesterday's high and today's high, both are very much similar, near to 10,700. And yesterday's R1 and today's R1, both are at same price level, around 10,700. Now today the candle also faced a stiff resistance near to that, even though it opened gap up. So mostly it looks bearish here. It might try to fill the gap, come down to central pivot point and take a good support there, because yesterday's closing level was at that price and today's central pivot point is also at that price. Now we'll shift to Bank Nifty. So Bank Nifty, already there's a sharp fall on 28th Jan and now price is trying to go up near its resistance zone. So earlier that was a trend line resistance, a trend line support. When it got broken, that got converted into trend line resistance. So we'll take the help of moving averages here. Let's see where the moving averages are. So trading below 9, trading below 20. So facing a resistance near 50 SMA. So you have your 100-day SMA here and 200-day SMA is also somewhere around the same point. Yes. So on 29th Jan, where did price take support? Exactly at 200 SMA. So when price takes support at 200 SMA, it has got lot of significance. So that means bulls are still strong here. All it needs is a good momentum or a good push, and that will come when there is any major announcement for banks. If that happens, then Bank Nifty will go up and it will also take Nifty on the upside. Now we'll also need to see where the positions are being built up for the next expiry. So first Nifty, if you see, the highest OI is at 10,700. So this might act as a support, but already Nifty is trading below that. So this might act as a support. And on the call side, if you see, 11,000 is still the resistance. But a lot of unwinding is happening at that strike price. Then if you come to Bank Nifty, longer side, 26,500 is having the highest OI. Low made is 26,440, very near to 26,500. So Bank Nifty took a clear support there. And in terms of OI resistance, it 28,000 is the area where there is highest OI. So it stands out somewhere around here. So for the next contract, people are definitely bullish on Bank Nifty. So that is clearly visible from the OI positions that they have taken. So 26,500, which is the 200 SMA of Bank Nifty, there the put option OI is very high. That means put sellers who are bullish on the stock or who are bullish on the index have established their positions, and call writing has happened near 28,000. If we zoom out, this is the area of resistance, the triple top pattern. And the area of resistance for Bank Nifty is at that price level only. Now enabling the pivot points and all those things. Based on pivots, it is already in bullish zone. What matters is, did it come down to central pivot point and take support there? Slightly. So the central pivot point is around 26,300. and the low made till now by Bank Nifty is 26,441, just around 140 rupees of difference between the support taken and the central pivot point. On daily time frame, it went below the central pivot point, but the 200 SMA acted as a very strong support to that. So overall, Bank Nifty is telling us that bulls are still active in this. All it needs is just a good news for banks. So then it can go up. So these are the support and resistance levels marked. So participants have asked two stocks, Bajaj Finance. First is, now see, even Bajaj Finance took support at the 200 SMA. So that's a strong bullish indication. So this comes under finance sector. If we have a good news related to finance sector tomorrow, then this 2670 will easily be broken and price will be bullish. Grasim is taking support near this monthly S2. Remember that these pivot points are valid only for today, because today is the last day of expiry. And long-term bullish divergence can be seen in this stock. From this point to this point. And it is happening at monthly S2. So it will have a good significance. What we need at this point is a good bullish candle setup. Shift to higher time frame and see if we have any support there. If we had a good support somewhere around here on the left side, that would have given us a good confidence. Because see here we have a strong support at this zone. So at least if price would have come down there, and if there is any bullish divergence at this zone, we could have initiated our bullish trade. So in the process of this bullish journey, accumulation has happened at this zone. So bulls will be stronger even at the 700 zone. But since S2 will be breached already, so tomorrow only we'll get a clear picture. With the new pivot points, we'll again look at this stock. Just remind me, tomorrow most probably we'll not have a market commentary. At least we'll see this on Monday. Just remind me in the market commentary on Monday. We'll again see this. Yeah, that's it for today. Thank you all for joining. Yeah, someone has asked ICICI Bank. So today ICICI Bank is in gainers. Good upward movement. So it jumped up from its previous support. Nothing much. Just it has taken its support and approaching its previous resistance. That's it. Yeah. Thank you all for joining. That's it for today.